digestive complications are reported in 40% of vascular EDS patients. The mean age for the first digestive complication is 28 plus minus 11 years. Almost all parts of the gastrointestinal tract are likely to be symptomatic. The first digestive complication often occur in patients who are not yet diagnosed with vascular EDS and might trigger the search for the diagnosis. Spontaneous colonic perforation are the most frequent first digestive complication. They often occur in patients who are not yet diagnosed with vascular EDS. They are often spontaneous, but some events are triggered by constipation, morphine treatment, or neuroleptics. Almost 50% of the patients will experience a second perforation, which can happen in the 21st month after the first event. The type of reversal surgery after Hartmann procedure influences the risk of reperforation. Simple reversal step versus prophylactic subtotal colectomy is more at risk for reperforation. Non-colonic perforations are represented by small intestine or gastric perforation. Diverticulitis is rare in the course of vascular EDS and does not seem to trigger colonic perforation. Spontaneous spleen rupture is the second most frequent first digestive complication. However, it is not associated with further digestive events. Gastrointestinal bleeding without identifiable artery rupture has been reported in the course of vascular EDS and is not infrequent. Colonic or small intestine volvulus have been described in a few patients. Gastroparesis can be triggered by neuroleptic treatment. However, it is not frequent in the course of vascular EDS, but has been described in the other subtypes of Ehlers-Danlos syndromes. There are no rectal prolapse or congenital diaphragmatic hernia in our patients. Intestinal pseudo-obstruction or postoperative adhesive obstruction have also been described and can be favored by morphine treatment. In most of the cases, vascular EDS is not known at the time of the first digestive event. Colonic perforations are not the only digestive event in these patients, but they are the most frequent first digestive complication. Such events have to trigger vascular EDS search and diagnosis. Males seem to be more prone to digestive complications and colonic perforation recurrence than females.